Flower shops are blooming with business for Valentine's Day as one of their busiest times of the year quickly approaches. And coming in just about every color, shape, and size, flowers are a Valentine's Day staple.
But if it's love, it's got to be a rose, right?
Has to be.
Yeah, all right. First News Weekend anchor Samantha Bender has more.
Many flower shops prepare all year for the big day.
We start preparing for Valentine's Day on February 15th of the year before.
Anne Marie with Blooming Crazy in Boardman tells me they start by assessing all of their orders to determine what worked and what didn't work. She tells me they found that
red roses are always the number one. So we had different lengths of stems, the long stem still number one. That's what everybody loves.
And this year, Valentine's Day falls on a Tuesday, which Tom Butler with Berkland's Flowers tells me means it'll be a busier year than last. His reasoning, it's further away from the weekend where many couples tend to go out to celebrate instead of buying flowers.
But when their spouse or girlfriend or boyfriend are at work, they always seem to like to send the flowers to work.
Floral shops encourage you to order sooner rather than later to ensure your flowers arrive on time.
If you wait till right at the end and you want it delivered on Valentine's Day, we're still going to try to do it, but we get so many orders, it's so hard.
And be prepared that you may be spending more on your flowers this year.
Usually our roses are going for $65, and right now they're going, for a dozen. Right now, a straight dozen's around $80, $85.
Tom tells me he attributes a lot of this to the cost of shipping and transportation going up. Reporting for WKBN 27 First News, I'm Samantha Bender.